Hi everyone, back to you again. Today's video we're going to do the 7-day forecast today, having a detailed look at weather for the week ahead across the British Isles. There's some big changes on the way, perhaps not in terms of the weather itself, but in terms of the setup in the atmosphere and eventually the temperature. We're going to find some much cooler, more seasonable type weather coming along once we get through beyond around the middle of the week. We're going to start to see frost and fog re-emerging. Now, before we get on with the video, I just want to mention the advertising. There will usually be a video ad overlay my web videos at GazWebBiz.com. Please play those videos. You'll be supporting GazWebBiz.com by doing that. And GazShop is still open. It'll be open till the end of January to get all your Amazon co.uk bargains from amazon.co.uk. Just click on the Amazon banner, go through to amazon.co.uk and buy your January sales items from there. Thanks very much for doing that. Finally, I want to mention the websites we're using for the video. We've got the chart coming from weathercentral.de and theweatheroutlook.com, and this one, the radar picture from the UK Met Office, which is where we're going to start. So this is the latest radar picture from the UK Met Office. We've got some rain coming in towards Ireland and approaching western the Western Isles of Scotland, but many parts of the country actually dry today. So the drier spell that set up last week continues. So have a look at the jet stream. This is where the jet stream is currently, and it's a very strong jet stream running out of Newfoundland in towards the Atlantic. Then it's shooting northwards to the north and west of the British Isles before diving southwards down over Europe. Now this jet stream streak here, pushing to the north and the west of the British Isles, indicates that we are on the mild side of the jet with an area of high pressure underneath. So this is why the temperatures have been on the mild side over the last few days. The temperatures have warmed up a lot, and it's because we're on the mild side of the jet stream, but things will be changing with this once we get through towards the end of the coming week. So this is the situation today. We've got the high pressure sitting here over the British Isles, the jet stream taking low pressure up to the northwest of the British Isles. We're on the warm side of the jet, or the mild side of the jet, and it's mainly dry. Now we are bringing a weather system in from the west, as we saw on the radar picture. Some rain heading in towards Ireland, and that'll get more widespread across Ireland and western Scotland through the course of this afternoon. But the rest of the country having a lot of dry weather, rather a lot of cloud really underneath that area of high pressure, but there will be some sunny breaks coming through at times. It's always more likely to the east of high ground and in the south of the east of the country, some bright or sunny spells coming through, but generally quite a lot of cloud. It's very mild again today, though, very mild for the time of year, with temperatures up to 10-11 degrees quite widely, 50 to 52 Fahrenheit. If you get any sunshine for any length of time, those temperatures could go up to 13 degrees, that's 55 Fahrenheit. Overnight, we're going to take that weather system across Scotland and Northern Ireland, and possibly the far north of Northern England as well. But high pressure is still dominating weather here at 1,030 millibars. So it'll be a very weak system, just producing cloud and light rain really for Scotland, and a little bit of patchy rain or drizzle possible for northern and northwestern parts of England as well. And in any case, that'll die out as we go through the night. Further south, a lot of dry weather continuing. One or two mist and fog patches developing, but also rather a lot of low cloud developing once again. Temperatures tonight will be very mild again for middle of winter. No frost really anywhere across the British Isles, with temperatures at around 5, 6 or 7 degrees. So a really mild night coming up across most parts of the country. That high pressure still dominating as we go into Sunday. It could be just the last vestiges of the light patchy rain or drizzle across Scotland Thursday on Sunday morning, but that'll die away. And then we're looking at basically another dry, cloudy day with limited bright or sunny spells and one or two mist and fog patches lingering for some time. Again, the sunshine always more likely to the east of high ground and in the south and the east, where we're close to this area of high pressure, or the centre of the high pressure. But really, it's quite a cloudy day once again. Not just as mild as it is today, but even so, still very mild really for the time of year, with temperatures at around 9, 10, 11 degrees. Heading into Monday, we've got this area of low pressure beginning to develop in the Atlantic. That'll be starting to spread wet and quite breezy conditions in towards Scotland and Northern Ireland through the course of the day. Eastern Scotland staying mainly dry, but Western Scotland could get some rain by the end of Monday, and that'll come down into Northern Ireland as well. The rest of the country is still under the high pressure, although the high pressure is starting to slip more to the south and the east. So we're really looking at a basically dry day again away from the northwest of Scotland on Monday, with good dry spells across pretty much whole of the countryway from the northwest, but it'll be rather cloudy once again with limited bright or sunny intervals. Could be more in way of mist and fog as well across England and Wales on Monday morning. That's one to watch out for. Temperatures again just a degree or two down, but still mild at around 9 or 10 degrees. Now, as we're heading towards Tuesday, we've got this low pressure to the north. Scott, this is bringing a cold front down across the country, and this really starts the change to much cooler conditions. We have very weak cold front because it's running into pretty high pressure, but even so, it will start the change to much cooler weather from the middle of the week. So, if I find a band of cloud and rain across Scotland, Northern Ireland, and Northern England on Tuesday morning. That'll push down into England, Wales, becoming very light and patchy with sunshine, just a few scattered showers following to the north. Now, it's still very mild in the south. Southeast was still mild with temperatures up to 10, 11, 12 degrees, very mild really in the middle of winter. But in the north, behind that cold front, it will be turning a good deal cooler with temperatures down to just 4, 5 or 6 degrees for much of Scotland. And the showers across northern Scotland may actually turn a little bit wintry. Going into a Wednesday, and high pressure is still dominating the weather really, but now we're in a completely different air mass. So although it's still basically the same sort of weather with dry conditions across pretty much whole of the country away from the north of Scotland, where there could be a few wintry showers, it's pretty much dry on Wednesday. Because the air mass has changed, we'll notice more in the way of sunshine, but we'll also notice quite a drop in temperature. So temperatures in the north are just 2, 3, 4 degrees, in the south around 5, 6, maybe 7, around the middle 40s Fahrenheit, but it'll certainly feel a good deal cool and fresh. And this is actually close to where we should be for the middle of winter. As we go beyond this, things start to get much more complicated. I've been talking in recent days about the stratospheric warming bringing much colder weather to the British Isles, and the signs of this is still in the models this morning. We're starting to show high pressure building up here over Scandinavia as we go through Thursday into Friday, with weather systems trying to come in from the Atlantic. What it means in terms of weather is that I think Thursday is basically going to be another dry day, but there could well be a widespread frost on Thursday morning with temperatures possibly as low as minus 2, minus 3, maybe minus 4 degrees in some places. So there will be a frost, I think, on Thursday morning, the first frost of the year. But otherwise, Thursday basically a dry day with more sunny spells, maybe some freezing fog patches around as well. But this weather system could just bring some cloud and rain towards Ireland and southwest England by the end of Thursday, so it could turn wet down there. But otherwise, it's quite a dry, chilly day, a cold day really, with temperatures in the north of just 1, 2 or 3 degrees, in the south, 4s, 5s, 6s. Certainly a good deal cooler than we've been used to. And then it's getting even more complicated as we go in towards Friday. The high pressure is building over Scandinavia, but we're bringing a weather system in from the Atlantic. So we've got a band of cloud and rain. Difficult to say how active that weather system will be, but certainly I think a band of cloud and rain coming across the country on Friday could turn wintry as it runs into this colder air in the northeast. So for northeast England, Scotland, don't be surprised if you get some snow on Friday. But I think for England and Wales, it's more likely to be rain. It will be quite a cold, dank, cloudy sort of miserable day with temperatures in the north of just 1, 2 or 3 degrees again, in the south just 4s and 5s. Again, it's feeling quite cold and dank under that, all that cloud and the rain coming in off the Atlantic. And then beyond this into next weekend, the models this morning are showing high pressure re-establishing across the country, but probably with a lot of fog next weekend. We do have to watch out for freezing fog next weekend. Temperatures will still be on the cool side, there'll be more hard overnight frost. And beyond that, there are indications that we might take the high pressure up to Greenland and pull down some very cold air in towards the middle of the month. But this is a long, long way off. We can't take it too certain at all. The jet stream forecast for the end of the week showed the jet stream is coming southwards, diving southwards down into the Atlantic and to the west and south of the British Isles now. So we start week with the jet stream going to the northwest. We end it with the jet stream starting to dive to the south of the country, and we go back onto the cold side of the jet. Finally, having a look at charts from the Weather Outlook, and we've got the mainly dry weather across the country today. There will be some cloud rain coming into the northwest, but it's mainly dry. A lot of cloud around, but a few bright or sunny spells. And it's mainly dry again for Sunday, although we have got some showery rain up here across Scotland, but it will be dying out, I think, very rapidly through the course of Sunday. More rain coming into the northwest of the country on Monday on that cold front. The rest of the country is dry and still mild. And then we have that cold front moving south across the country. country on Tuesday as a weakening feature. It's still mild in the southeast, but it's turning colder behind that cold front. And by the time we get through to Wednesday, well, there's a lot more in way of sunshine here, but temperatures have taken quite a tumble and we're back down to where we should be for the time of year. There could well be a frost on Wednesday night, and Thursday will be a dry day, I think, with a good deal of sunshine, some rain coming into the far southwest, but it's mainly dry on Thursday. But temperatures are on the cool side, with frost early night, possibly some fog patches as well. And then on Friday we take that weather system in across the country, could give some wintry weather for northeast England and Scotland. We have to watch out for that, but otherwise it's just rain, and it will be quite a cold, dank sort of day on Friday. And beyond that, into next weekend, we're looking at dry weather re-establishing, but it turns increasingly cold, I think, with frost and fog. So that's the pattern that we're looking at for the coming week. In summary, we're starting off on a very mild note across many parts of the country. Tuesday, we find that cold front coming down across the country. It will be quite a weak cold front, but it will change the air mass. From Wednesday onwards, we're looking at a much cooler setup, much cooler temperatures, with frost and fog probably becoming increasingly likely into the latter stages of the week and next weekend. And then there's just that question mark with some rain possibly turning wintry in the northeast on Friday. So a much more seasonable feel on the way. That's it for now. Thanks for watching.